You can significantly improve gaming performance in your laptop by using two sticks of memory instead of one. Using one stick is known as single channel, while two sticks is known as dual channel. And I'm going to show you the differences between both in games at 1080p and 1440p resolutions so you can see what the differences are and decide if it's worth moving from one stick to two sticks. And spoiler, it's worth upgrading to two sticks. I'm going to compare using one 32GB stick against two 16GB sticks, so either configuration will have the same 32GB of total memory capacity. All memory runs at the same DDR4 3200 speeds with same timings. And it's all dual rank too. The same principle applies using two 8GB sticks versus one 16GB stick. The reason I've chosen to use 32GB in total is to try and rule out capacity limitations as being a bottleneck, so that we can focus purely on the changes between single and dual channel. I'll be using the AMD Ryzen 7 5800H processor for this comparison, along with RTX 3070 graphics inside the XMG Neo 15, the same Tongfeng chassis as the Electronics Mech 15G3, an excellent gaming laptop that I've previously reviewed on the channel. I've done all testing with Optimus Disabled for best gaming performance, but it could be possible that Optimus-enabled laptops do see a bigger boost with dual-channel memory, as the integrated graphics rely pretty heavily on the laptop's memory. Anyway, let's get into those gaming comparisons. Cyberpunk 2077 was tested in Little China with the Street Kid LifePath. I've got the dual-channel results shown by the red bars, and single-channel results shown by the purple bars, which are slower. I've also tested all available setting presets, which are listed on the left with lowest settings down the bottom and highest up top. At 1080p with ultra settings, we're only seeing less than a 1 FPS boost to average FPS. However, the dual channel config has a larger 12% boost to 1% low, so more stable on dual channel. Stepping up to 1440p, and at most setting levels, the difference in average FPS is now even smaller. Higher resolutions are generally more GPU bound. The memory difference seems to affect CPU bound tests more, so lower resolution and lower setting levels. That said, again, there were even larger gains to the 1% lows compared to average FPS with dual channel. Red Dead Redemption 2 was tested with the game's benchmark. Single channel was still offering above 60 FPS with ultra settings. However, simply by running with two sticks of memory was enough to boost average FPS by more than 21% here. The difference was similar at low settings too, with a 22% boost to dual channel now. At 1440p with max settings, the dual channel config was still 21% ahead of single channel. The difference was actually smaller at lower settings. Fortnite was tested with a replay feature using the exact same replay for both memory configurations. The difference at max settings is basically nothing, both for 1% low or average FPS. Then we can see the gap slowly increases as we step down to lower setting levels, where finally with the low setting preset, the dual channel configuration was 14% faster in average FPS. Again, like most other games tested, the differences at 1440p are smaller for the most part. Low settings was still 7.5% ahead with dual channel, but then at pretty much all other levels, we're not seeing much change at all. Control was tested with and without ray tracing. Let's start with ray tracing disabled. This is a GPU heavy game, which likely explains why there's only a 2 FPS difference max at medium and high settings, though dual channel at low settings was able to get an 11% boost to average FPS. The results are quite close at 1440p too, though this time even low settings was only around 2 FPS different for the averages, so only minor changes. With ray tracing on at 1080p, there are once again basically no real differences. Dual channel had a slight edge, but realistically not any practical improvement that's worth paying for, given both could still hit 60 FPS max settings, with a difference that's within margin of error. Things are again even closer at 1440p, though the frame rates are cut a fair bit at this higher resolution, and that's where DLSS comes in. With DLSS enabled at 1080p, there's now a larger difference between the two, again more so in regards to 1% low performance. So it seems that dual channel is able to offer a more stable experience with DLSS enabled compared to disabled with just ray tracing. At 1440p, the difference is smaller, but again, still a subtle win for dual channel. At least it's not a step backwards, I guess. Microsoft Flight Simulator was tested in the Sydney Landing Challenge, and this game saw the biggest difference out of all 11 games tested at 1080p. With dual channel, we're able to get a 32% boost to average FPS at max settings compared to single channel, while low settings pushes this up to a 36% higher frame rate. There were still excellent gains at 1440p. At max settings, the 1% lows were very similar, but apart from that, dual channel was offering great gains. A good example of a game where running in dual channel is going to help you out. Assassin's Creed Valhalla was tested with the game's benchmark. Like many of the others tested, the difference at higher setting levels is smaller compared to lower. And again, like many others, the difference in 1% lows seems to be larger than average FPS. So a more stable experience on dual channel. Things are even closer together at 1440p, though either configuration is still very close to 60 FPS at max settings. So you're really only going to see better performance at lower levels that don't hit the GPU as hard. Watch Dogs Legion was also tested using the game's benchmark, and there were bigger improvements in this one between the two. Dual channel was 19% faster at low settings, but then only 7% ahead at max settings. At 1440p, max settings were about the same now, though low settings was still able to offer a 16% boost compared to using just one stick of memory. Battlefield 5 was tested in campaign mode. This one had above average improvements with dual channel memory too, 11% higher average FPS at ultra settings, and then a larger 17% boost at low settings. 1440p also had some nice gains with dual channel, however the differences appear to be larger with the 1% lows in most cases. Shadow of the Tomb Raider was tested with the game's benchmark, and was another that also saw above average improvements with dual channel. There was a 27% boost at low settings at 1080p, and 17% higher average frame rate at max settings with dual channel. At 1440p, max settings was now just a 2fps difference. However, there was still a decent 17% boost at lowest settings with two sticks of memory compared to one. CSGO only saw a small difference. At 1080p, just a 10fps gap at medium and max settings, or less than a 3% improvement with dual channel. And then 1440p wasn't much different either, but I'll discuss why I think this result was smaller shortly. Rainbow Six Siege was tested with the game's benchmark using Vulkan. This one seemed to have a larger difference when it came to 1% lows. The averages weren't that much different at all, and then they're even closer together at 1440p. The single channel config was actually 1-2fps ahead for some reason here, but things are so close both for the average and 1% lows that this is margin of error stuff. It just seems like Rainbow Six doesn't really care which memory config you use at this resolution. These are the differences in all 11 games tested at the lower 1080p resolution with all games set to the highest setting level. On average, the dual channel configuration was just under 9% faster when compared to the exact same laptop but in a single channel configuration. Some games saw basically no difference, while others like Flight Simulator or Red Dead Redemption 2 had pretty large gains with two sticks of memory. The differences increase with all setting levels now set to the lowest level, with the dual channel configuration now almost 16% faster than single channel in the same selection of games. For the most part, lower setting levels are more CPU bound, so the memory difference is affecting the results more compared to higher setting levels. I didn't expect CSGO to show almost no change here. When I've compared single and dual channel in the past, this same test saw a 23% boost with dual channel. But this could be because I've tested with Optimus Disabled. Laptops that use the iGPU may see more gains with dual channel. When we step up to 1440p max settings, we only see a 4% improvement with dual channel. Higher resolution, along with higher setting presets, are typically more GPU bound. It of course depends on the game, as we can see here. Red Dead Redemption 2 and Flight Simulator are basically outliers compared to the rest of the other results that saw much more modest differences, but regardless, still a performance gain with dual channel. With all settings at minimum, the dual channel configuration was now 9% faster than single channel on average at 1440p, so lower than the 16% gains we saw at 1080p with minimum settings. Flight Simulator once more dominated the results, but many of the other games were also getting a bigger performance boost now compared to max settings. I've also tested both configurations in content creator workloads to see what the differences are outside of gaming. Adobe Premiere was tested with the Puget Systems benchmark. The dual channel configuration was scoring 9% higher than the single channel one in this video editing workload. Adobe Photoshop was also tested with the Puget Systems benchmark, and this time there was a larger 15% boost to the score with the dual channel configuration, so non-gaming workloads are still able to get a reasonable improvement. If we look at buying a single 32GB stick of memory, it's $145 on Newegg at the moment, while two 16GB sticks from the same company are just $25 more at $170 in total. I think this price difference is well worth it. However, most people would already have a single stick installed. Given you can't upgrade most laptops' CPU or GPU, I think this is still one of the best simple changes you can make to boost gaming performance. Buying another stick that's the same size, speed, and timings as your existing stick is an extra cost that I think is worthwhile relative to the larger cost of the laptop itself. So running two sticks of memory in dual channel does boost performance, but it's not always quite that straightforward. I've done all testing here with both sticks the same size. You can still run dual channel with two different size sticks, say one 8GB and one 16GB. However, this can cause performance issues. Using different size sticks is known as asynchronous dual channel, and it's a whole different topic that I would need another video of this length to go through. So make sure you're subscribed for when I look at comparing different memory configurations in a future video. If you're looking for more ways to easily boost gaming performance in your laptop, then check out these videos over here. You can get some fairly significant performance improvements with some simple tweaks. So I'll see you over in one of those videos next.